Hello, guys, and welcome to episode 8 of the Daniel Pike podcast. And today, returning by no popular demand, Matthew Oxley, Holly Adamson. Welcome back, everybody. Today, I'm looking even redder. I've had a haircut. That's the main one, really. This is the second time I've had a haircut and recorded the same day. But that doesn't mean anything. Today, we have got a true crime special because I ran out of ideas. So we've each gone away and found a true crime case, which we will get into in about 5 to 10 minutes. But first, I just want to talk to everyone. How has your week gone? It's been back to school this week for all of us, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. How's it been? How's it? What? Anything exciting happened?
Holly, I reckon you go first.
I mean, I had exams, so very fun. Wow.
That's exciting,
yeah. Yeah, really exciting.
Love that. Love that with you.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what's exciting. I went to Primark today after my haircut. Look what I picked up.
Holy. I got sunglasses. Holy. I literally got sunglasses yesterday.
And I also got a pair of silver ones. Ow.
Was that by choice? Or were you forced to get them?
Oi! These made me look cool.
Alright, okay. You do, mate.
I look like an Oompa Loompa. If I stand, look, you can see my light shining off my. So I can. I look like an island.
I'll turn mine on.
I'll turn mine on because I'm definitely a YouTuber. No, that's going off.
You've just got a lamp in it.
Yeah, it is just a lamp. It's a bendy lamp.
I bought LED lights, but I didn't have to set them up. So, what do you mean?
I'm going to turn mine on just to bring some flavour.
Bring some sauce. Bring some muck sauce. What's the most exciting thing that happened in the last sort of week or two? I don't know.
Is it me?
Go on then.
Okay, I ordered loads of clothes on Shein and they all came and they all fit.
Summer clothes.
Yeah. Summer.
I'm already sunburned. My shin is now in half because we were playing football. In physical education, and I went to block the shot of like the strongest guy in our year. So instead of kicking the ball, it's a solid connection through my shin. So if I didn't have shin pads on, ouch! And it still hurt through my shin pad. So
you got to jog it off. You wear shin pads when you?
I jogged it off. I don't want to break my shins. That's the exact thing that I wouldn't want to.
Like shin pads, they hurt more than the ball hitting my shin does.
It's not the ball hitting your shin that hurts, Holly. Yeah, silly woman.
Yeah, it does. I don't care about getting kicked in the shin.
What? So you don't mind, right? Okay, you don't mind getting kicked in the shin, but the ball hitting you in
when
the shin.
No, when it's like wet.
That is
bad.
No, like when on a cold wet day and you get hit in the shin with a
in stone.
Ball on the thigh.
Not Polly. That's awful.
Get mentally abused.
What was that?
That was my sunglasses. I also, what else did I buy from Primark? I bought some socks. Some socks. These ones got pineapples on them. Shorts. Shirts. £62. £62.
Oh, that was like
in Primark.
I know.
I just got better stuff. What can I say?
I thought they had like a £5 limit or something in Primark. Wow.
I know. I'm very adventurous with the clothes I wear.
Threading white shirt, though.
Right then. Now that we've spoken and had a nice conversation, why don't we get into our first case of the day? It's going to come from, who's got the most exciting one?
I haven't read mine.
It's going to be Matt.
Matt, actually, Matt, you go first then, if you haven't read yours before, and then we can go along and incept as a pair. Then we'll do Holly, and then I'll finish this session off then.
So, okay, I don't really know what I'm doing, to be honest. I'm just gonna kind of read it.
Right. So, what is the case called, Matt?
Well, it says the Papin sisters who murdered their bosses in cold blood.
The Papin. Is it Papin or Papin?
No, Papin, mate. Papin. Papin. Papin.
Should I put some sinister music over the top of this? Let's get some sinister music. You ready? Ready? Ready?
Yeah.
Soundtrack for a supervillain. Here we go.
It's a bit rude.
Demons.
Yeah, you are. Us can now switch energy
in as little as one click. Yeah. Yeah. I'm scared now.
Terrified.
I'm scared now.
Never mind. Right, just go. Yeah, give up. Just go. Give just up. Go. Just go.
Right. I haven't read this, so it could be anything. Right. French sisters Lia and Christine Papon worked as living servants for the Lackland family.
Living servants.
Shut up. In 1926, although it was reported that they acted quite odd, it's a bit rude, never talking to anyone but themselves and showing little interest in anything besides each other, according to historic mysteries. They did their work quickly and lived with the family for almost 7 years. And one night in February 1933, Mr. Lacklin, it's probably not said about that, but anyway, who had been waiting. Huh?
Lachlan? Is it Lachlan?
I think it's actually Mr. Who cares? He was waiting for his wife at a friend's house. So, you know, classic party back in those days. Bloody love and life. He came home to find her and their adult daughter dead on the floor in a pool of blood. Ooh.
A murder.
Their eyes had been gouged out and faces mashed in. The Papin sisters were locked in their room. And after getting a locksmith to open the door, the police said they found the sisters lying on the bed together with a bloody hammer nearby. It's a bit rude. I need to swear at the hammer.
Isn't
it? According to the Vintage News, the Papin sisters immediately confessed. Oh, that was crap, wasn't it? That was it.
Was that it? That can't be it, Matthew Oxley.
While in prison, Christine became very distressed from being away from her sister and was eventually granted permission to see Leah. Reports said that the sisters seemed so unnaturally close to each other, with some suggesting a sexual relationship, though doctors who examined the Papin sisters denied evidence of that. A few months later, Christine suffered a mental breakdown and tried to gouge out her own eyes. After the trial, Christine was sentenced to life in prison for being the mastermind behind the murders, while Leah was eventually released from prison in 1943. Managed to get a job at a French hotel under a new identity. It is believed she died in 1982. It's never been confirmed. Pretty much what I've got, is I've got this website and it's literally just tons of different, not very well known crimes. So that was it. Pretty crap.
Well, well done, Matt.
Well, we know who did it. That's the main thing.
There's not much I can really talk about in that because you just explained everything straight away. So,
listen, the briefing was poor, I'll be honest. The
briefing was poor, was it? Yeah. Just bring a true crime case. Don't do it like, 10 minutes? I listened to my story, by the way, on the bus and in a damp warehouse, so I could have been killed. I'm kidding.
Oh, I did mine 10 minutes ago, so I think, you know, who's the real winner here?
Out of 10, Elizabeth.
Like a 5.
That was incredible, don't you mean?
I'll give it a 3. Didn't have
I'll look for another one.
The only bit that got me was when she gouged her own eyes out and that she mushed the faces. But apart from that,
is that all we're looking for? The gruesome factor. Is that what?
Like things that make you go, "Wow, that's a weird case."
All right. Okay. I'll look for something. All right. Else. I apologize that it's not up to your standards.
Well, do better and come back stronger. That's what my father said to me. Okay. And moving on to Holly's story or true crime case, the red lighting in the background matches the ominousity and blood and it can it has connotations of death. But enough rambling. What is your case called, Holly?
Okay, well, I am a genius, so you have a choice between two.
Well, do one.
Here, pick a name. What was he? 10-year-old boy called Nicholas Barkley, or a 30-odd-year-old man called Peter Falconio?
Do you want to do the brother of Ross Barkley?
Sure.
I'm disappointed, to say the least, I must say.
Okay, I can't be bothered to read this because I've read it so many times before. It's kind of interesting. Thing for me, I don't know. Anyways, it was like this little boy. Stop. This little boy called Nicholas Barkley was 12, right? And
you said he was texts 10. His mom.
He's like, no, yeah, I was wrong. Anyways, he tells his mum that he's shush. Stop listening.
Oh, I've read this story so many times, but I've given two different ages in the first minute.
Okay, so he tells his mum, he's like, oh, I'm going to go play basketball after school in the little playground thing. So I'll be back a little bit later. So he is like, I'll be back at this time. Can my uncle come pick me up? Where did Daniel go? His uncle comes to pick him up and he's not there. And they're like, oh, where is he? So then they put out this missing thing and they can't find him anywhere. And his uncle is really sus. He's like really creepy. I don't know.
The uncle's really sus. You can't just go to the uncle.
I think he's a little weirdo. So they get a call 10 years later saying, we found the guy who matches your son's description and he's alive and he's been sex trafficked.
How have they done that though? Because he's 10 years older. That's outrageous.
Isn't they found him?
Yeah, but how? Surely they can't have done it with the same photo.
He shows up to this payphone out of nowhere, calls the police and is like, yo, someone help me. So they take him back and he tells everyone, he's like, yeah, I got taken all over Europe and I was being sex trafficked from 12 years old onwards. And he couldn't speak American. He couldn't speak English very well because he'd grown up the rest of his time in France and Russia. So he was speaking Russian and French.
Oui, oui.
And the police were like, this is kind of weird. And the family were just like, yeah, it's him. It's him. We love him, he's home. And then the uncle was like, it's definitely him, don't investigate it, guys. It's him, it is the kid. And then this police chief was like, I don't trust this. This guy is blonde, has showed up to a phone. What?
I want to take a break. You told me he got kidnapped when he was 12.
Yes.
How can he not speak English at 12?
That's exactly what I was thinking.
Well, here we go. This is why the police
progressing the plot.
The police chief is like, this is looking kind of weird. I don't trust this. Why can't he speak fully English? Hella sus. He didn't like it. So he was like, right, we're going to get a picture of the guy when he went missing and the guy now and put them together. And they were like, obviously, because it was 10 years ago and this guy's older now, he's going to look different because he's grown up and no one's seen him since. So he's putting together all the features and he's like, yeah, most of them check out. And then he's like police genius and the ears are different sizes and it's like,
no freaking way.
Shut your mouth. Sorry. It's like a fact that your ears don't change size. Like your ears don't grow.
Do they not?
No, apparently not.
I'll tell you what, my ears did not come out this big when I was born. I'll tell you that for free.
Apparently they don't grow. So they were like, that's crap. They were like, this guy is not your son and you've been living with him this whole time. What are you doing? He's not your son. And they were like, he is my son. He is my son. You cannot tell me he's not my son. So then they take him into questioning, and they're like, we know that you're not Nicholas Barkley. And he is like, yeah, I'm not Nicholas Barkley. He's a serial offender who has, he's actually 34, not 22, as he was meant to be. And he goes round pretending to be missing children. Like, he looks on missing children registers and calls the police and pretends to be them. And is like a serial offender, will go and live with them and then run away after stealing their money. And then Nicholas Barkley was never found.
That's a dub.
That was a bit sad.
I thought it was pretty interesting.
That the ending bit was actually really interesting. If you'd drawn that out and then given it like a little bit of space, then we would have had some fluency.
Your ears do grow, by the way. You're lying, Holly.
Oh well, the police detective thought they didn't. So.
Well, he's wrong. Well, no, I think they said they grow, but. Yeah, apparently gravity, bloody gravity, you know, makes your ears sag and your nose sag. So when you get older, you're going to have a saggy nose and saggy ears. That's what I've been told.
Saggy-tarius.
Please don't speak. That was horrible.
Okay. Right, I'll go now while you guys find your second ones that you already have. Okay. I'm going to lead you through the case of Nico Jenkins.
Or Milana.
Jenkins. Or Nico. It could be Nico. It's probably Nico Jenkins, actually. Let's call him Nico Jenkins. Okay. I've said that name too many times now. Okay. Nico Jenkins, born September 16th, 1986, is an American spree killer. Now, a spree killer, to anyone who doesn't know, is not a serial killer. So they do all their killing in like quick succession. So he did all of his inside a month, and he did it on October 2013 in Nebraska. So he killed four people in August 2013 in Nebraska. So the murder occurred within a month after he had been re-released from prison after serving 10 and a half years of the 21 years that he was actually given. So this was, so basically he was actually, that will come out later. I'll explain that a bit later. But I just want to let you know that he got released after 10 and a half years, despite being given 21 years in prison. So he'd still be in prison now and not killed these four people if he wasn't. Okay. Jenkins stated that he had committed the killings at the command of the ancient serpent god Apophis.
Yeah.
Now, Apophis is like this snake god, and he kept saying that it was in his ears, it was telling him what to do. So he was found competent to stand trial, so he was found like mental health enough to stand trial, not insane. And he was found guilty of the four murders and was the first Nebraskan death penalty since they reinstalled the death penalty. Since he installed the death penalty. So now let's bring this back a bit. Let's talk a bit about him as a youth, a youngster. Ruthless. My style is a quick drinks break. So Jenkins was born in Colorado to parents David Maggi and Laurie Jenkins. His family was known for being notorious violent criminals dating back generations, and he and his siblings' childhood were all filled with violence, physical abuse, and criminal activity by their parents. So, you know, like most serial killers, they had he wasn't a serial killer, he was a spree killer. But most killers, you didn't have a great upbringing. His first known criminal act, are you ready for this, was when he brought a gun to school at age 7.
Same.
So he brought in his mother's handgun at age 7 into his school, and when he was asked about this in the future, he said, oh, it was a voice in my head, who I now know is, what's his name? Apophis.
Gavin. Oh.
Gavin.
What's his name?
Apophis.
Apophis.
A-P-O-P-H-I-S.
Oh, I should give it a name like Clyde or something.
He didn't name it.
Yeah, he should have done.
He also got his criminal record at age 15 for hijacking and aggravated assault. Okay, so he was put... Okay, so this is where... This isn't on the Wikipedia page, but I know this bit. So he was put into prison for that aggravated assault and given 10 years. And then he was put on parole for like a week or so for his grandma's funeral. So his grandma's just died. He's been allowed out of prison. What does he do? He does it again. So he was now given the same penalty twice. So 10 and a half years. So that should take him to 21 years. But the judge said that he was going to do it like at the same time. So 10 and a half years and 10 and a half years. So they just cancelled each other out. And I that's a rule apparently. And I just think that's so stupid. Like, if you do the same thing twice, surely it'll be 10 and a half plus 10 and a half, not 10 and a half both together.
That is ridiculous. What the hell? Surely that can't be right. Is that actually a thing?
That's actually a thing. It was like, it can either be what's the word? I can't remember.
I understand what you mean.
Yeah. So, here is the murders. About 5 a.m. on August 11th, 2013, a patrol officer discovered two bodies in a white Ford pickup truck parked near a city swimming pool at 18th and F Street in Spring Lake Park.
Better.
The two victims, identified as Juan Arribe Pena and Jorge Sicajaiga Cruz, had been shot in the head and their pockets turned inside out, so robbed. They were lured there thinking that they would be able to have sexual relations with two women. So he was like, come here, have sexual relations with two women. Oh, okay, we are Juan Arribe Pena. The random double murder began Jenkins' spree less than 2 weeks after his release from prison on July 30th.
Can you do that? Are you allowed to?
What did I do?
You can't make the accent.
What?
You can't do the accent.
What did I do? What? The Juan Arribas. Juan Arribas.
Stop.
It's Mexican. It's Mexican.
He might not be Mexican.
That's true. just Juan, hello.
Please stop. Just keep going. Please keep going.
Okay. Hello, everybody. It's Juan here. I'm not making fun of the murders, people watching the podcast. I'm just lifting the mood a bit.
Just keep going. You're digging a hole. Just keep going.
Okay. On August 19th, so 8 days later, around 7 a.m., the body of Curtis Bradford was found outside a detached garage at 18th and Clark Street by a man returning home from a night shift at a convenience store. Investigators arrived to find two bullet wounds in Bradford's back. I love it. I hate it when I get shot in the back and it leaves a bullet wound. You know me.
Oh, yeah. Good old bullet wound, eh?
In Bradford's back. This is the person, Bradford, not the place. It was later revealed that Bradford and Jenkins had posed for a Facebook photo the day before.
Bradford would be
the only victim familiar to Jenkins. So they actually knew each other in prison, I think. They knew each other in prison.
Oh, fun.
So when he got out, he visited him like 3 weeks afterwards and then killed him. Because that's the nice thing to do.
All fun and games, eh?
Jenkins' fourth and final victim on August 23rd, so 2 days later from the third murder. A gift from Zoom, running out of time. We've removed the 40-minute limit on your group meeting. Love it.
Ooh! Hey, no way it's been 40 minutes already.
I don't think it has. I haven't even started the timer. It's been like 20 minutes.
Already?
Yeah, already.
Oh, you're
has it actually been half an hour?
You're robbing a...
to be fair, actually, you took a while, but it says 8:33.
All right, let's just say it, because I started this at around 8:10. So we'll just go into
it. Filming an episode out there. I'm saying that right now.
This is a good episode. I'm doing all the work here. Yeah. I'm only halfway through my story.
Okay, keep going. I apologize.
Jenkins' fourth and final victim, Andrea Kruger, was discovered on August 23rd.
Keep going.
On August 21st, about 2:15 a.m., by a deputy sheriff responding to a shots fired call. Her body was found... Shots fired. Her body was found lying in the road at 168 and Fort Street with multiple 12 gorgy shotgun wounds to the face, neck, and shoulder.
Gorgy.
Wait, say the sentence again.
With multiple 12 gogs shotgun wounds.
Spell the word.
G-A-U-G-E.
It's gouge.
Gouge. All right. Kruger had been returning home after a bartending night shift near 178th and Pacific Saint. Surveillance footage showed her locking up the Deja Vu lounge at 1:47 a.m. At 6:30 that evening, Kruger's gold 2012 Chevrolet Traverse SUV was found abandoned 12 miles away in an alley at 43rd and Charles Street. Later that week, a news conference was held by Douglas County Sheriff Tim Dunning, in which he had stated that investigators believed the SUV had been abandoned roughly 2.5 hours after being stolen and that a feeble attempt had been made at setting the vehicle's interior ablaze.
So he
probably tried to steal the car, realized that he couldn't sell it, and then tried to blow it up, and then he didn't.
That's outrageous.
Okay, so now we're going to move on to his arrest.
Oh,
like a three-part story. This is like burger.
I'm sorry, but that is incredible.
That is what? Actually
purple.
Look at the fade.
What is it, by the way, in a nice way?
It's a Galaxy Light.
Samsung Galaxy.
If you want to watch the unboxing video, just check out my YouTube channel.
Man's Red Steel.
That is not the YouTube channel, but I think.
Matt Oxley.
Link in the description. Okay.
I might put it in the description.
I'm gonna put mine in the description. Shut up.
I think I'm alright. I think I'm fine. On August 30th, 2013, Jenkins was arrested on an unrelated terrorist threat. Okay, maybe I shouldn't. Jenkins was arrested on an unrelated terrorist threats charge. By then, evidence against him had mounted. Investigations had the image of a female associate on surveillance footage at a local gun outlet buying the kind of distinctive ammunition, Brennecke Classic Magnum 12 Gouge, commonly known as deer slugs, that had been used to commit the killings. So they'd find someone, give the specific gun to person. Additional footage had been pulled from cameras along the road to Kruger's abandoned SUV. On the evening of September 3rd, Jenkins confessed to all four murders during a rambling 8-hour interview. Jenkins told the police the acts were sacrifices to
the snake god.
Apophis, yeah. A deity in the ancient Egyptian.
Oh! No way! Oh! Sorry.
The ancient Egyptian religion. He was charged with four counts of murder following the confession. Oh. Now we're going to move on to his trial. Now this one's a long one, so have fun with this.
See, listen, I don't understand how you can't like the trial of the Chicago 7. I know you watched 5 minutes of it, but that movie is literally...
I didn't like it.
It's just this, but as a movie...
I want to watch it.
In handwritten letters dated November 3rd, 2013, submitted to the Omaha World Herald, prosecutors under George Jenkins said that he wished to plead guilty to all four count into four slayings, and that he would protect Apophysis. Apophysis' kingdom with animalistic, savage brutality. Yeah, this is where. I mean, it wasn't a nice story in the first place, but it isn't very good anymore. On February 19th, 2014, Jenkins filed a federal lawsuit seeking $24.5 million from the state of Nebraska for wrongfully releasing him from prison, stating that his claims of hearing voices from Apophis were repeatedly ignored. In the six-page handwritten filing, he stated that being kept in solitary confinement augmented his schizophrenia. He blamed corrections officials for the four killings. So after confessing, he was like, yes, but it was, I shouldn't have even been out there anyway. Why give me 2 10-and-a-half-year charges, but only keep me in for 10 and a half years? That doesn't make any sense. I've done half my trial. Don't put me in solitary confinement when I've told you that I've got schizophrenia. So at this point, has he got a point? No. Like, obviously, you can't justify killing four people, but if you are meant to be in prison at the time, and... Well, how would you... Say, like, I don't know, your mum was given two 10-and-a-half-year trials, and only did 10 and a half, only did half of them, so she was only in there for half the time she was supposed to, and then she goes out and kills four people, and then she goes, but... I wasn't even supposed to be out there anyway. You didn't listen to me. I wanted to be in there for my own mental health.
Well, what would the real you do? Question is, my mum does. She doesn't have schizophrenia, unfortunately. So.
Okay, your friend with schizophrenia.
Unfortunately.
I don't have a friend with schizophrenia.
Okay, let's just... okay.
I'm kidding.
Johnny has schizophrenia now.
Now, this is a good point. Okay,
Johnny has been given 2 10-and-a-half-year sentences. Johnny's come out of prison, killed four people. What's your opinion then?
God, he's still fat, isn't he? But I think...
God.
I don't know. It's a crap excuse, is my opinion. It's just lazy at this point.
But if you do have schizophrenia...
That is not a good enough reason, in my personal opinion. Get a grip of yourself. Walk it off.
Well, to be fair, if he had the if they knew that he had schizophrenia already, they needed to give him the mental assessment to see if he was actually fit to go back out into the public streets after killing people. So, it's their fault.
Well, basically. No, he didn't kill anyone at the time. He
said he had schizophrenia that made him commit crimes. So,
wait, what is schizophrenia again? Hold the phone.
It's when you hear voices and they can tell you to do stuff. And they're like, I'm going to kill you, like some of them. They're like, run in front of a bus.
That is true.
And like people, like a lot of people that have it, like kill themselves and stuff from it. Like my dead uncle, I don't know.
His schizophrenia is from Apophis. Or Apophis.
Apophis.
Sorry, I just need to blow my nose.
Yeah, take your time. So, come around here often.
Yeah.
It's not nice to come in here and mock your guests. You can't. That's not how you get.
No. You're not even paying me.
There's no change there. God, you know what? I'm not surprised you didn't get the main part in this.
No, shut up.
I'm gonna be honest.
I got Edwards. I'm fine with Edwards. I'm fine with Edwards.
Imagine not being the love interest.
You have to read a Latin poem. I don't want to hear it.
But I get the females.
You have to sing, Daniel. You have to sing.
You do. That's true. That's quite true.
That I need to sing. Oh, when the beads. All right.
Come out the den.
Oh, when the beans come.
No. Go. Continue.
You put the bread.
Keep going.
And the toaster. And then you put it. Right.
Am I allowed to come? Yeah.
He blamed.
Is that not allowed? Cool. Podcast?
Just go ahead. Just smash open a cold one.
I will be back.
Oh, I'm going to cry if it's Corona.
Let's have a quick 5-minute break. Let's have a quick 5-minute break. Okay, this is a new question that I'm going to give to everyone. Okay, top three fast food restaurants. Go.
KFC.
Right, decent enough choice. Not the greatest, I'd say, but we move.
McDonald's.
That's like more like it.
I don't really eat fast food, so there I have two. Domino's. Does that count?
Yes, Domino's does count.
Okay, so those three.
Very good, very good. Favorite order from each of those. What do you order? What's your go-to order?
Okay, I don't really get fast food that much, so I don't... Okay, Domino's would either be pepperoni pizza or margarita pizza.
Good.
Probably
good.
Margarita. Their margaritas are so good. Ooh. The KFC bonus banquet, because I get the same thing every time because it's so good.
See, when I go to KFC, I'll always get a 3-piece set chips and then... what's it called? The popcorn chicken.
And then McDonald's, I would get either large fries and the chicken sandwich thing, or large fries and 6-piece chicken nuggets with a Diet Coke.
And you can watch us eat McDonald's in the mukbang coming very soon and very terribly. Terrible video.
I was so ill the next day. I couldn't eat. I didn't eat the whole day until 8. I couldn't eat.
I ate later that day.
No.
That's a lie. I felt really ill afterwards.
I had pizza for dinner that day, and then I didn't eat anything the whole of the next day except from two little piece of watermelon and some chips.
It's because what is it? We walked straight away and then did a bunch of basketball. And it's like, oh, God, that didn't...
Oh, yeah, I didn't even walk basketball. I managed it. I was so good because you left. And then Drew tried to teach me how to do the, shots.
Yep.
And he was like, do as many in a row as you can. And I cannot shoot, but I got 14 in a row. So what I'm going to say is I'm a legend.
Remember when you nearly broke the table?
Literally, that was not me. That was you. You silly. Oh, can I have one?
What'd you get?
What do you think, Daniel?
What alcohol did you get? Sorry, I was sending a message to my friend. What alcohol did you get?
What do you think? We cannot hear you.
We can't hear you.
We cannot hear a thing you say.
I wasn't speaking.
Oh, right.
Yeah, right.
I was just saying, this is actually not alcohol, and I am over 18. For YouTube reasons, this is water.
Well, we promote all types. This video is not sponsored by Heineken? Is it
Corona!
Heineken? Oh, sorry.
Sponsored... How dare you? Heineken? I'm the person to take people.
Oh. San Miguel!
Guinness.
That was so great.
Guinness. I'll tell you what. Do you like a good Guinness? But when it's not alcoholic.
Yes.
Don't drink and drive.
We don't drink alcohol. And we're over 18.
Actually, Holly does. But when Holly drinks alcohol, she only needs a beer and then she's gone. She's a bit...
No.
Well, luckily for me, I do not drink alcohol.
Dan, you'll get there, mate. You'll get there for now. I'm what they call a social drinker.
Mostly. Me too, but I'm always social.
Shut up, Polly.
All right. We've had a nice break. Oh, Matt, while you're here, top three fast food things. Top three fast food restaurants aren't.
Restaurants.
Or best places to go out and eat or order.
You literally said fast food before.
Yeah, but it's like the same thing.
So is this like KFC, Mackey's, that lot?
Yeah.
Top three.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna have to be a bit awkward here. And it's like music, it's like a movie. It all depends on the mood that you're in at the
Right, time. Yeah.
So
Yeah.
My number one, probably my go-to, would probably have to be KFC. You just can't beat a good KFC.
You two are very similar there. What's your order? What's your go-to order?
Oh, you just got to get a bargain bucket. Normally, that's just what you get. You got to get, because when you get the bargain bucket, you get everything. You know, you get the stuff on the bone. Listen, I'm a connoisseur.
What's in a bargain bucket? What's in a bargain bucket, by the way?
You've got the wit. You've got. It depends what you get. I swear. How many pieces is in it? Is it 10? Oh, you can choose, actually, I think. A 10-piece bargain bucket. Shut up, Holly. You can get, like, I think it's a 10-piece bargain bucket, and it's, like, spicy wings, or, like, spicy, but yeah, spicy little wings.
Oh,
and you've got, Holly, I'm talking.
Thank you.
Shut up, Holly. Shut up. And then you've got, like, you've got the legs, and then you've also got breast. I think you have breast in there as well.
Oh, cheeky. You've got,
it's...
So awful.
Oh dear. Right, yeah. Continue, Endo. Drinking all the pain away.
Gonna need more than that to drink the pain away, fella. I don't know, really. I've got bloody messing this up. Apologies. I don't know. It's just bloody nice. Anyway, the other ones. If you're looking for something quick, I don't recommend, but Mackey's would have to be up there.
Go to order.
Just 20 chicken nuggets, really. Because that's the only reason I would go to Mackey's for the 20 chicken nuggets.
Speaking of McDonald's, very disappointing mukbang coming out.
Mukbang.
Sunday or Monday.
Mukbang. It's a mukbang.
Mukbang.
It's a mukbang. Not a mukbang.
Andrew.
What are you eating, Ollie, in it?
20-piece chicken nuggets. And a chicken sandwich and large fries. We'd been walking all day.
And how many nuggets did you eat?
10.
What? No way.
You know, Sinead's was the next day. You remember, I didn't eat anything the whole day. And then I kept being like, I haven't eaten anything all day. I was so ill.
Whose fault is that? That is not my fault. Listen,
you're
a disgrace. How can you literally only eat 10 in a 20? Literally, it's one mouthful. You just chuck it in and it's...
Yeah, but I got large fries and a chicken sandwich thing too. And
so, listen. You don't eat food. You don't like a lot of food.
I don't even...
No, you do not. Shut up. No, you don't. You do not eat food. On the scale, no, you do not. Listen.
I do.
How are you so offended by this?
You came to my gaff for the barbecue. How much did you eat?
To be fair, I did forget to eat.
You forgot to eat when I barbecued. I barbecued so much food. The vegetarians even ate. The veggies ate. What did you do? You were sat in the corner. You were just like, because you had a cider. You've had a singular cider and you are gone.
I had two.
Oh, two. That is embarrassing. That is honestly embarrassing. Two ciders and you're just sat there like, who am I?
No, I was not.
Yes, you were.
I wasn't.
Yeah, you were literally dancing. There was no music playing and you were dancing.
There was not.
I do that all the time.
Yeah, but man, you're not on alcohol most of the time. This young lady, two sliders.
Name food and I will eat it.
That's not the point that we're trying to make here.
I eat food constantly.
No freaking way. Otherwise you'd be dead, wouldn't you? Lol.
Why aren't you eating food now?
I could if I would.
Yeah, but you'd only have half of it, wouldn't you?
Okay. Gosh,
a bit too much for you. A bit too much for you.
What did you say?
Let's move on.
I got six nuggets and then a 9-nugget meal to go with it, large, with large fries, obviously. And then I got chicken mayo, no mayo, add ketchup, add tomato, and then a large Pepsi. And I donated 20 pence to charity.
So, and I did
you
not.
Absolute legend.
And then, we haven't done your third. What's your third? Matthew Oxley.
My third. depends. It depends what you class. We're not fast food. Is it still fast food or is it takeaway? Is it just fast
takeaway?
Food?
Takeaway can count.
Oh, but then that changes everything. Because if it's not fast food, then that changes the entire order.
It doesn't matter. Wait, you can just...
Wait, so no, you could have like Indian and Chinese.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I can't say that's fast food.
That is not fast food. No, that is outrageous. Just because it's a takeaway doesn't mean it's fast food. That's shut true. Up.
All right.
So this changes everything. You've got to go.
I'm going to have to redo mine now.
Shut up. First up, it's got to be Indian. You cannot beat me on that. You cannot beat me on the Indian. I was going to say you can't beat the Indians, but yeah. Anyway. then you have to go Chinese always. Indian, then Chinese. Mm-hmm. I don't care what anybody says, you know. And then...
Chinese is better.
You know what? I think I'd put KFC. Thing is, I never had sushi, and I really want to try some sushi.
I've never had sushi.
I want to try sushi.
I've had Wagamama's.
But my friend really likes, I don't know, I don't like ginger, like raw ginger and stuff.
Oh, that's mad.
I have a ginger nut right here.
The one that I've got.
No, that's fine, but like a block of ginger.
Proper, like actual raw ginger and stuff.
You have blocks of ginger.
He had like ginger sushi, and I was like, oh, yeah, I'll try. No. But I had avocado sushi as well. That was nice.
Avocado on toast. I am a white person.
I'm not a big fan of avocado. Okay.
Does that mean I get to do mine again then?
Go on then. No. But while you do yours, I need to go to the toilet. So you.
Okay. I'll run the podcast.
Just
hi guys.
Go through your Indian and Chinese meal, and then Holly, you do your order. You read it.
Okay, mine will be the exact same as Matt.
Oh, you wanna take me home tonight? Oh, you might get coffee like that.
Right, what would you order?
No, what would you go for? Are you going Indian and Chinese, and then what would you put third?
Because we always get loads of stuff and then we always share it, so I can have whatever I want. So I don't
spoil. Bloody hell!
Love a jalfrezi.
Jalfrezi.
Yeah, and I love a jalfrezi. I love a korma.
No, what would you get third? I said.
Third, KFC.
Oh, okay, all right. Okay.
I thought we're doing our orders. I said orders.
No, I was asking. I was like, because I didn't hear what you said was third, so.
Oh, okay. Well, what's that?
I'll tell you what, actually. Fish and chips does bang. It depends where you get it from, but you can't get it to fish and chips.
I forgot that kind of well, I like
Yeah, on the beach. You can't beat it on the beach, to be honest, but, yeah. You're on this.
Now.
What? I didn't say anything. Oh my god, you know, we literally have complete control right now. We can say anything and he will not realise, and he'll just have to put it in because he's not gonna check through this.
True.
So are we just gonna
That was so crunchy.
To all of Daniel's family watching, hello. Come and see Blue Stockings at Shinfield. You will recognise me because I am the womanizer within the group. And it's not a good look for me, I'll be honest. But it all turns out fine and dandy in the end.
That was really good.
I don't know why I was looking at my wall, to be honest.
What would you order?
Ralph Mayhew. I have 168 lines. I have to speak Latin to a young female.
168 lines? I have more lines than you now.
Maybe I don't have 168 lines. Let me have a look. Let's go check.
I apologise, everyone.
You won't want to take me home tonight. Oh, down beside them, red fine line. Sorry. Let's have a look. Who did you get? Who was the part that you just got given?
I'm not allowed to tell anyone, so...
You've literally already told me.
Yeah. Miss Blake.
You heard it here first, chaps. Right. How many lines do I have?
Sorry, Gordon. I know you told me
not. I've got 140 lines. You're Miss Blake. Literally. You've got 165 lines.
Yeah.
How did you go from that? Oh, to be fair, you've got a really crap partner.
I do. I don't even know who she is. So
oh, she's a lecturer.
Shut off. So I don't know why she's not doing it, but we can't tell Daniel because I'm not allowed to tell anyone. I already told you, but like,
you know, this is literally going on YouTube. You know that,
yeah,
right?
But I'm not allowed to tell anyone until tomorrow because Gordon's going to tell everyone anyways. So it's
okay. I'm going to message the Shinfield group chat now.
No, please don't.
I'm just going to say hello, Miss Blake.
No, please don't. No,
I'll put a smiley face next to it.
Okay, it's not. I thought you said something else.
Holly.
No! Stop. I don't like it. Matt.
And it's done. It's done. We've done it, guys.
What has happened since I've been gone?
You've missed an awful lot. You're not going to be able to upload this, Dan, I'm going to be honest.
Okay.
Kidding.
Let's go back.
Kidding.
Okay,
Matt, are you kidding?
What?
What happened?
Oh, basically. You know what we were doing last night on house party? When I was doing my COVID test?
Yes. No, you're lying. You're lying.
Right. No, I was just promoting. I was promoting the Blue Stockings.
All right. Yeah. Okay.
We were discussing the part that Holly has.
What, Miss Minnie?
Minnie.
Yes, Miss something.
Minnie.
Miss.
Minnie.
What's her name? I believe it begins with a B.
Minnie.
Blake.
Minnie.
All right, now should I finish my story about the serial killer?
I'm going to be quite honest. I did not hear half it if you kept going because I went and got alcohol. So
No, I didn't keep going. We stopped.
It was water.
We stopped just for you, Matt.
Water.
I did. And the voices inside my head.
Thank you, Dan. Much love, my bread Ryan.
All right, so we're going to continue water. From the schizophrenia bit.
Right.
So just to bring you up to date, just in case you've forgotten. In solitary confinement augmented his schizophrenia, so he blamed it all on his schizophrenia. Okay. Jenkins claimed that his problems were caused by mental illness and that he had schizophrenia, bipolar disorder, and OCD. The judge ordered a psychiatric evaluation, which I think Holly said earlier. And a psychiatrist concluded that Jenkins had antisocial personality disorder and was faking psychotic symptoms. So he was making it all up.
No freaking way. He's a genius.
After being declared competent to stand trial, the proceedings against Jenkins commenced. On his request, Jenkins was allowed to represent himself at trial, just like, what's he called? Ted Bundy.
That is a great movie.
I love that movie so much. I was rooting for him to get away.
You just like Zac Efron. Shut up. You just like Zac Efron.
No, I don't. Why would you think that?
All right. Throughout the trial, under the guidance of advisory attorneys, so he represented himself. Throughout the trial, Jenkins maintained that he acts under the command of Apophis. His courtroom antics included speaking in tongues, howling, and laughing as prosecutors recounted the details of his victim's death. Not a very nice man.
Doing a dance in the middle.
Huh?
Is he the one that started doing a dance?
No.
In his trial. He was like, there's literally like him going like, he was like, psycho.
On April 16th, 2014, Judge Peter Battalion found Nico Jenkins guilty of all four murders. Jenkins was initially scheduled to be sentenced on August 11th, 2014. The date was delayed indefinitely following a hearing held to determine whether he was capable of understanding the death penalties against him. So if he had an IQ large enough, I think that means. On July 29th, Judge Battalion ordered Jenkins to be housed at the Lincoln Regional Center Psychiatric Hospital, until doctors were satisfied with his condition. Officials at the regional center refused to house Jenkins due to inadequate security, but doctors agreed to treat him at a Lincoln prison. That's Lincoln in USA, not in England. That'd be a bit of a long trial. In May 2017, Jenkins was sentenced to death by a three-judge panel. He was also sentenced to 450 years in prison if he doesn't get the death penalty on weapons charges connected with the murders. On April 20th...
Wait, so that's just for the weapons?
That was just for the weapons.
450 years for the weapons. 450
years.
I reckon he can outdo it.
On April 20th, 2020, the US Supreme Court refused to hear his appeal. So he is still alive to this day. And do you want to see a picture of him?
Yeah. Because then I'll know if he's like the... Oh, he's not, no. Oh! Okay.
Don't you dare say he's attractive, Holly.
Oh, no, I wasn't going to... Tattoos on his face. I'm not loving the tattoos on the face, can't lie. Yeah. Why are you looking at me like that?
He actually, by the way, he in prison, he tried to cut his winky with a razor to make it look like a serpent.
Legend.
Fun fact. And he tried to write 666 on his forehead, but he did it the wrong way around. So it's just 666, but the other way. So it's like 999, but upside down.
Always that, fun.
That is the end of the trial that took way too long.
It did.
That's quite good, that.
So.
That was pretty interesting. Fucking tons.
Out of 10.
Holly.
It was kind of long. So, like, a...
Okay, Holly, your opinion doesn't matter. Personally, I would give it a... I would give it an 8. I would give it an 8 if I'm being clinical.
So a 6. And an 8. That goes.
I gave it
seven.
A 7.
Okay, then a 7 and an 8. That gives it a 7.5. All right. So, I hope you've all enjoyed this episode of True Crime / Food, Fast Food / Something That I Might Have to Check Is Allowed. Matthew Oxley.
It's all allowed. Trust me.
Thank you for watching. If you are new, make sure to subscribe to the channel. Make sure to like and make sure to share it with your friends. The more people we can have watching this podcast, the more money I make, the more good
Dan's family
can bring in. That is, if you guys want to see these people again, if you, for some reason, would want that, get this video to 5 likes. I know you can do it. Get this video to 5 likes, and we'll think about doing it again. That's all from me. And the non-alcoholic in my left.
That went down the wrong way.
Say goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Fight Brexit. Kidding.